selfies. Whether you love them or you hate them, you can't deny that it's sometimes necessary to take them when you want a picture of you and your four-legged pal, and there's no one else around. Following these simple steps can help you have an easier time in getting that quick pic with your pup, and over time it can result in a really cool party trick. Using a treat, call and lure your dog over to whichever side of you that you'll prefer, so either your left or your right. If your dog already has a good recall, you can use that, so for instance, come or here, any form of recall that you want. Vixen and I are using swing because it's what she already knows, and for those of you that don't understand why I use swing, it's basically because she is literally swinging around, kind of like in a J shape, to do basically an about face. This can be a good starting point on learning recalls because when practicing this, you'll be starting at the beginning and only requiring your dog to come over to you to a short distance. Click and reward your dog when they come over to you. Call and lure your dog over, ask them for a sit, and then click and reward. Make your dog hold the sit for a few seconds before clicking and rewarding. This is setting up that time you'll need out in the real world to pull out your phone or your camera and take the picture. And you can increase the time that they're holding the sit as you feel necessary. For this step, I'm going to be using the stay cue with Vixen. If you're new to practicing stay with your dog, this can be a good beginning spot because you're only asking your dog for a few seconds. Add in a verbal cue when you feel you and your dog are ready, and even further down the line, you can begin to fade out the treat or the lure. After some repetitions of the whole process, you'll find your dog is taking less time to interpret your hand signals, and this is when I recommend adding in the verbal cue and fading out the treats. Some fun verbal cues for this could be selfie, or let's take a selfie. Your dog will have a better time generalizing this trick if you vary up things like location, time of day, even your clothing, and also who specifically is doing the training session that day. Keep your training sessions lighthearted and fun, and gradually increase distractions. Don't be afraid to take a step back if needed, and most importantly, always end your sessions on a positive note. I want to thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and go ahead and share this video with your other dog-loving friends. And if you're not subscribed, go ahead and click that subscribe button. We'd love to have you over here, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye!